This is so exciting that we have almost finished the stylings and the interface of our overall application. Now the only thing that's remaining is the logic and the magic of this application. So I hope that you are super excited and you learned a lot of things while building this project. And now we are finally going to jump on to add some magic to this application. So in this video, I am first going to tell you why do we need a separate component for this particular string, and then we are going to finalize our state for this particular application. So let's get started. So firstly, as I told you that instead of keeping this as a paragraph, I would be keeping this as a separate component. Each letter is going to be a separate component. So this is just my design implementation. For you, it could be something completely different because every person has their own way of styling things. Every person have their own way of designing the interface. Every person has their own way of implementing the application. So for me, I found it quite logical that for changing the colors as soon as the user starts typing, for example, let me type some words. Firstly, let me type the correct letter, A. So when I type A, this color is going to get changed. When I type S, this is going to change to green. And then when I type F, or instead of F, let's type T. It's going to be wrong. So that's going to show, the red color is going to show that you typed wrong. So basically this orangish yellow color is going to show us that this is not yet attempted. Green color is going to show that this is correct, and blue and the red color is going to show that this was incorrect. So a simple way to implement this particular action could be to render each and every letter inside a span as a separate component, and then we can provide a different styling to every particular component based on our input. So this was the reason why I was telling you in the previous video that instead of rendering a paragraph directly, we would be creating another component as we saw in our component architecture diagram. So yes, now let's jump on to the state of our application. So let me remind you what does our state looks like. What is a state basically? So again, in case you haven't checked it out, do check out my previous videos as well in the AAM series itself, in which I have talked about all the basics of React and, for example, states, props, component architecture, and how are components formed and so on. So yes, but still I'll remind you very quickly that state is nothing but the data that we want to save in our application across one session that might be used to render on the screen, or that might be used for some logic, and that might also change from time to time. For example, here the words. Words is something, it's variable. It's going to change from time to time. As soon as we start typing, the number of words are going to change. And we also need to save it so that we can continuously show it on the screen. We need to save it. We need to save number of characters. We need to show them continuously on the screen as soon as we type. Also, we need to change it as soon as we start typing. Speed is again something that needs to be saved. Timer, the time remaining, that is also something that we might need to save because that is going to change. The selected paragraph and so on. So let's have a look of how our state is going to look like. So for those who are new to state, state is nothing but a JavaScript object. JavaScript object is nothing but a key value pair, just like dictionary in Python. So JavaScript object is nothing but a key and a value, a list of key and a value. So yes, so the structure of our state is going to look something like this. Firstly, we are going to save the selected paragraph. So the selected paragraph is going to be hello world, for example, just for now. I am going to tell you how to fetch that new paragraph or things like that in the next video. But for now, let's suppose our selected paragraph is hello world. We are also going to show whether the timer is started or not. And we are going to use that to render this particular text. If the timer is started, then we don't need to show this start typing to start the test. But if the timer is not started, then we do need to show this. So yes, timer started boolean will control the conditional rendering of this particular text here. Then finally, we are also going to save the time remaining. The timer remaining or the time remaining will render in this timer. We are also going to show the number of words that we have typed, the characters, and the speed in WPM. So let's jump onto the code very quickly and see how are we going to implement it. So as I told you in the beginning that our app component is going to be a stateful class-based component and everything else is just going to be a functional component. Again, for those who are worried about whether or not I'm going to teach about React hooks, don't worry, I am going to cover everything in the React hooks as well. But I have seen this particular thing a lot while teaching React to beginners, that people are able to grasp the concepts well inside the class-based components due to the easy differentiation between render method, lifecycle methods, and the state, rather than jumping onto functional hooks directly. So let's create our state equal to, state is going to be this JavaScript object, where first of all, I'm going to add selected paragraph as, for example, hello world. This seems good enough for now. After some time, we are going to remove this to be an empty string, and then we are going to fetch those particular paragraphs. But for now, let's just keep it selected paragraph. And then the Boolean called timer started. Initially, the value of this is going to be false. Time remaining to show on the timer. For now, let's keep it 60 seconds. Or even better, let's have a sort of constant outside our class that is going to define the number of seconds remaining so that we can change it afterwards as well. So I'm just going to name it total time. This looks good enough for me. So I have done nothing. I have just created a constant of total time outside my class just to use it as a constant inside it. So that, let's say if I'm going to use this some other places as well, so I don't need to use that hard-coded 60 second or something else. Instead of that, I am just going to use the total time as a constant. Words for starting, the words of course are going to be zero. Characters are also going to be zero, and the speed in WPM is of course going to be zero. This looks good enough, and let's also quickly use the state everywhere we want to. So mostly we are going to use the state inside our challenge section. So inside our challenge section, I am going to first of all pass on the selected paragraph as this.state.selectedParagraph. Then I'm going to pass on the number of words, probably words is equal to again this.state.words. Then I am going to pass the characters equal to this.state.characters. Something which I have seen people doing a lot, they think that the name of the key is should be the name of the key of the prop should be the same as this one. This is not at all true. You can name it anything that you want. For example, instead of WPM, I can name it as speed, and that is completely okay. This.state.WPM. That's completely fine. But for now, let's just keep it WPM as well so that I'm able to remember the names. So yeah, I am just not going to do that for now. So yes, this dot state dot time remaining. And finally, I am also going to start use the timer started as this dot state dot timer started. This looks super cool. And now, as I told you, the bad thing about using Native React and not using the modern concepts is that you would need to again pull all the things inside the props object. As I told you in the previous videos, like every functional component can be passed this props, and from the props we can actually use the props that we pass. So these, all of these things are called props. So for example, I can just console.log my props dot selected paragraph, and this is going to print it. So let's confirm this thing very quickly. Let me open this at the bottom and let me just quickly close it. So as you can see, let me refresh this page. Hello world got printed. If you want to confirm, it's printing from here, from challenge section. This was actually printed from here. So let's refresh the page once again. From challenge section, hello world. So as you can see, we can actually use these props. So one modern way to actually do this, instead of props dot this, props dot that, props dot abc, props dot xyz, we can directly destructure it inside our arguments itself. So instead of using props dot selected words, props dot characters and so on, we can directly just use this particular syntax to pull out the individual variable out of the particular props object. WPM, and then timer started, and then so this is going to be a boring task, because at each level we would have to pass on these particular state variables, and that would be something super annoying. And that's why I told you in the beginning, I love Redux. Redux solves this problem very, very efficiently, and you don't need to worry at all. Probably in a couple of months, or maybe 2 or 3 months from now, or maybe the next month itself, I can decide. I have not yet decided, but yes. So let's see which one am I going to take. But for now, let's focus on this one itself. So yes, let's pass on the timer remaining. So basically we would need to pass on almost everything, because we need all of those things here. So again, the name, the key of those props need not be the same as the variable name which we are passing inside it, but for my simplicity, I'm just doing that. So you don't need to do it at all. So yes, we can just quickly copy and paste this whole thing and paste it inside our test container. I know I'm going fast, but this is something which I believe should be very, very simple to understand. So yes, I guess you should not have too much trouble understanding it. And why is it showing the red marker? Because we have already defined time remaining inside it. So we can safely delete this, and now we can do this. Awesome. So let's test it out. The time remaining should now show 60, which is awesome. Cool. This is okay. And then inside our try again, we do not need anything apart from words, characters and WPM. So we are good to go on the try again section. But on the typing challenge container, we need a lot of things. We probably need almost everything that we have been passing till now. So yes, we need the time remaining. We need the timer started as well. We also need the selected paragraph as well to actually render the selected paragraph. So inside our typing challenge container, of course, I am going to copy and paste this whole props object, because we are directly passing this props object from one child component. So as you can see, let me remind you the component structure diagram. We are passing all those props from app to challenge section to test container to typing challenge container, three levels down the line. I know it's super, super annoying, but trust me, this is the way that we start learning React. If I would have directly jumped onto the modern concept like using Redux library, then you probably would have become confused. So yes, don't worry, we are going to cover everything in the upcoming projects. So yes, but for now, let's quickly remove these as props and use the copied one, which the things that we copied from our test container, because we need almost everything here. So now the best thing is, we can now, at least for now, we can pass on the selected paragraph instead of hello world. We can pass this on, and as you can see, now we are using the selected paragraph here, hello world. And if I change it from my app dot JSX, let's say if I say my name is Madhav, it is going to show me my name is Madhav, which is super cool. So now, as you can see, inside our typing challenge, we are actually showing these the timer remaining and the start typing to start the test and all these things. So yes, let's pass on the time remaining and the timer started to this as well. So this is just one final level of passing these props. Trust me, after that we won't need to, but yes, for now just deal with me. So inside our typing challenge, we can import the time remaining and the timer started from our props object, and the timer started, and we can use it here. So yes, here instead of showing the 60, I can actually show the real time remaining. So now we are showing the actual value. Let's confirm that. Let me change the time. Let's say remaining total time as 50 or 30. It did change to 30 seconds. So yes, let me undo that. And yes, we are using that. And this one, again, I am going to show you how to conditionally render. So basically, we are going to see a quick magic here. Not literally magic, but this is a trick in JavaScript, basically. So I can actually do something like this. Timer started. So let's start with ternary operator itself. So if timer is not started, which is not timer started, if this is true, which means that timer has not started, then I need to render this statement. Otherwise, I don't need to render anything. So I can write undefined. Undefined. So a quick way to do that, instead of using a ternary operator here, we can actually remove this and we can replace this by AND operator. So basically what it will do is it will first check this Boolean condition. If it's true, then it will go here and it will return this particular statement. If not, then automatically it's going to return the false or undefined. Let me quickly change it to be true and let's test it out whether it works or not. Yes, it does work. So there, in this case, it did not show up. So let's just quickly do it as false. And yes, we are seeing it. So just one last thing, very quick, before ending this video. So as you can see, in the cases where time remaining goes less than 10 seconds, for example, let me just do it 6 seconds. In this cases, it won't show double number, like double digit number. So what I'm going to do here is very quickly, I'm just going to add one more conditional statement, which is going to be my is timer or time remaining. If time remaining is greater than equal to 10, in that case, I'm using a ternary operator. I'm just going to render the time remaining. Otherwise, if it is less than 10, then I am just going to quickly append a zero or prepend a zero in the whole expression. So yes, time remaining, very simple. So this is a template literal basically, which we can use to inject some string inside our string, inject some variables inside our string. So now if we just quickly save it, you will now see 00:06. And that is super awesome. So let me just undo the 6 to 60 and we are done for the day. We have actually made the state. We have actually used the state in this every section that we are doing. Although we are not updating the state as of now, we can type anything and the timer or the test will not start. But for now, we are actually good to go in this particular state for this particular state. So yes, that's it for this video. See you in the next video. Take care. Bye bye.